I welcome my dear students, all of you, to the class of chemistry on 15th January 2021. Now we want to study, or we have, let us revise what we have studied into the previous period. We have started studying about the buffer solution. We know that blood and urine are the buffer solution. So buffer solution is a type of solution which resists the change in pH on dilution or with addition of small amount of acid or small amount of alkali. That is what it is known as the buffer. We can prepare two type of buffer solutions. Buffer solutions can be of two type, acidic buffer and basic buffer. Buffer can be prepared by using, acidic buffer can be prepared by using weak acid. Weak acid and the salt of weak acid. Salt of weak acid.
Meri marzi.
With strong base. So this is how we can prepare our acidic buffer. Acidic buffer is prepared by this method. So we can take the example. So we can prepare, we can take a weak acid and its salt with the strong base. So we can take the example of acidic buffer, which is made by mixing CH3COOH, CH3COOH and CH3COONa. This is the weak acid and this is the salt of CH3COOH with NaOH. This is strong base, and thus we can pre. So this pH has got pH. This buffer has got pH less than 7, and this pH less than 7 for this buffer is possible due to the presence of this H plus ions. The salt is believed to be completely dissociated, whereas there is an equilibrium between the weak acid undissociated and the ions CH3COO minus and H plus. Then, my dear students, we have started studying about the buffer action. So we have seen what happens if we add some amount of alkali, that is OH minus, from the outside. So when we add Y mole of OH minus, this OH minus combines with H plus. So when this OH minus combines with H plus, the neutralization reaction takes place, we get water. Thus the concentration of H plus decreases. As the concentration of H plus decreases, my dear students, what happens? This CH3COOH, which is undissociated, it produces more amount of H plus, and thus the concentration of H plus can be achieved C alpha. And as, but the concentration of CH3COO minus is increased, but as the concentration is achieved C alpha for H plus, pH is maintained. Now this extra Y mole of CH3COO minus, this reacts with Y mole of Na plus and produces Y mole of CH3COONa. This is what it is produced, Y mole. And thus the concentration of CH3COO minus also is maintained to C alpha. Thus the ionic balance is being maintained. And you can see that the solubility of salt decreases. So we can say that this buffer action is mainly based on the two principles. One principle is the principle of Lee-Chatelier, and the second principle that we can say is the common ion effect, and common ion effect decreases the solubility of the salt. Same way, if we add some of the H plus ions, my dear students, let's say Z mole of H plus ions, if we add, then the equilibrium is being disturbed, and that is why the concentration of H plus becomes C alpha plus Z. So concentration of H plus increases, thus this extra Z mole of H plus ion reacts with CH3COO minus ion, so that, or uh, So this extra H plus ion, my dear students, they react with this extra Z mole of H plus ion, they react with the CH3COO minus ion, which are present in the solution, and then they give the CH3COONa undissociated, and here the concentration of H plus can be maintained C alpha, because the extra Z moles of H plus react with the CH3COO minus to give us the CH3COOH, not solid, my dear students, but so this Z, so they give CH3COOH, not this. So this extra Z moles of ions, as the concentration of product H plus is increased, the equilibrium will shift towards the undissociated acetic acid, and Y mole of undissociated acid is produced by the Z mole of H plus ion reaction with CH3COOH. So my dear students, this H plus reacts with CH3COO minus, and this solid CH3COOH is being produced, and thus the concentration of H plus is maintained C alpha, and thus the pH is maintained. So if we add small amount of H plus or small amount of OH minus, or we can add the small amount of acid or small amount of alkali, the pH remains constant because the concentration of H plus is maintained to C alpha, and thus the buffer action can be, and thus this is how the buffer solution, acidic buffer solution, behaves. Now, my dear students, we want to study how to calculate the pH of acidic buffer solution. To prepare a buffer of acidic pH, we use weak acid and its salt formed with the strong base. So here, my dear students, we developed the equation relating the pH, the equilibrium constant Ka of weak acid, and then the ratio of concentration of weak acid and its conjugate base. So let us try to see, if weak acid is Ha and salt of Ha with strong base is Ba, it dissociates or ionizes in the water. So Ba completely dissociates to gives us A minus and B plus, my dear students. Ha will gives us Ha, when it reacts with water, it gives us H3O plus and A minus. So for which we can write, for this dissociation or for this equilibrium, we can write the equilibrium constant for acid, which is the concentration of H3O plus multiplied by concentration of A minus divided by concentration of Ha. And for that, if we write H3O plus concentration from the same equation, if we want to calculate the H3O plus concentration, then we will have Ka multiplied by the concentration of Ha divided by the concentration of A minus. So that is what I have written for you, my dear students, that concentration of H3O plus is equal to Ka multiplied by Ha divided by A minus. Remember that Ha and A minus are conjugate acid base. See, if you take Ha and if you remove H plus ion from it, it gives us A minus. So this is conjugate acid of A minus, and this is conjugate base of Ha. Does Ha and A minus make conjugate acid base pair? Conjugate acid base pair. This is how, my dear students, we understand that Ha and A minus are the conjugate acid and conjugate base. So taking logarithm both the side, we can have, see, we had this equation, concentration of H3O plus is equal to Ka multiplied by the concentration of Ha divided by concentration of A minus. So if we take logarithm both the side, minus log of H3O plus is equal to minus log of Ka minus log of Ha divided by A minus. Thus, minus log of H3O plus, we can write pH, minus log of K, we write pK, minus log of HA divided by A minus. But we know that log of A by B is equal to minus log of B by A. So for minus log of HA by A minus, we can write log of A minus by HA. So that is what we have written. Therefore, we can write pH is equal to pKa plus log of A minus by HA. Now, what is A minus? A minus is conjugate base, and HA is the weak acid that we have taken to prepare this solution. So instead of this concentration, we can write pH is equal to pKa plus log of concentration of conjugate base A minus and concentration of weak acid HA. This square bracket represent the molar concentration. So pKa is equal to pH minus log of conjugate base divided by weak acid. So you can see here that we have got an equation. pKa is equal to pH minus log of conjugate base divided by weak acid, or pH is equal to pKa plus log of concentration of conjugate base divided by weak acid. So equation, these two equations are called the Henderson-Hasenblatch equation. And this term A minus divided, concentration of A minus divided by concentration of HA is the ratio of concentration of conjugate base, that is anion, of the acid and the concentration of acid present into the buffer mixture, my dear students. Now we know that, my dear student, that here we have used the weak acid and it salts with the strong base. Since acid is a weak acid, it ionizes to a very small extent, and thus the concentration of HA is negligibly different from the acid taken into the buffer solution. Also, most of the conjugate base, that is A minus, comes from the ionization of salt of weak acid with strong base. So you can see that, my dear students, if we have CH3COONa, the X comes from the X mole of CH3CO minus and X mole of Na plus are present. When CH3COOH dissociate, it dissociate or ionizes partially and gives us alpha minus CH3CO minus and C alpha minus H plus ions. This being a salt of a weak acid with strong base, dissociate or ionize completely, and that is why the concentration of conjugate base A minus, that is CH3CO, see this, total CH3CO concentration would be X plus C alpha. So it will be X plus C alpha. Same. But my dear students, this X is very big because X is the concentration when the acid completely dissociate, when the salt completely dissociate, but this dissociate partially. So we can say that X is quite greater than C alpha. And therefore, X plus C alpha is approximately X. So that is what I have written, my dear students. And thus, the concentration of, and what is X? X is the concentration of salt. X is the concentration of salt, because whatever the concentration of salt you take, these all concentration dissociate. So X, this X is the concentration of salt. So we can say that the number of CH3CO minus ion represent the concentration of salt. Therefore, the concentration of A minus is equal to concentration of salt. That is what we can write. At the same time, my dear students, C is the initial, C is the concentration of weak acid, whereas C alpha is the extent of ionization. C is quite greater than C alpha, and therefore C minus C alpha, we can write C. This C is the concentration of weak acid, that is equal to C minus C alpha, that is approximately is equal to C, which is the concentration of weak acid we have taken, and that is what we represent it as a square bracket concentration of acid. So now, my dear students, instead of those terms which we have written into the Henderson equation, what we have written it in this manner, that pH is equal to pKa plus log of, we have written A minus divided by HA. For A minus, actually, it is the concentration of our salt, and for HA, we write the concentration of acid, and thus we can have the new form of this equation, that pH is equal to pKa plus log of concentration of salt divided by concentration of acid, which we are used to make the acidic buffer solution. So by using this equation, my dear students, we can easily find out the pH of acidic buffer solution. Now, if you have any doubt, you can ask me, or we can move to study about the basic buffer solution. Do you have any doubt, dear student?
No, sir, no doubt.
Thank you. Now, let us study about the basic buffer solution, my dear students. Basic buffer solution is prepared by mixing weak base with the salt of this weak base with the strong acid. So, basic buffer solution is prepared by mixing weak base with the salt of weak base with the strong acid. The examples are weak base NH4OH is mixed with the salt of NH4OH with HCl, which is NH4Cl. So thus we can have the buffer solution, which is basic buffer solution. And this basic buffer solution is prepared by mixing NH4OH and NH4Cl in the proper ratio. In proper ratio. So when we mix them in a proper ratio, we get the buffer of desired pH. But as these are the weak base and it solves with the strong acid, we will have the pH of this buffer solution always greater than 7, and that is why this buffer solution is known as the basic buffer solution. Again, here, my dear students, the salt dissociates completely or ionizes almost completely and gives us the ions NH4 plus and Cl minus, but our weak base does not dissociate completely and generate an equilibrium between the undissociated base and the ions. So this is how we represent the various concentration of the ions. You can even see here that the total concentration of NH4 plus ion is equal to X plus C alpha. And again, please remember that the concentration X is quite greater than C alpha. And that is why we consider the overall concentration of NH4 plus ion is equal to X. So while doing various calculations, we will take the concentration of NH4 plus ion is equal to X. pH of the solution of buffer can be determined by the concentration of OH minus. So these OH minus are the responsible species for determining the pH of this basic buffer greater than 7. Now we will see what happens if we add the small amount of acid or base from outside. So buffer action, first we will adding acid in the small quantity. So if we add Y mole of H plus ions, you can see that this equilibrium that has already been established. So this Y mole of H plus ion reacts with C alpha mole of OH minus ion, and initially there was no water produced, but when Y mole of H plus ion reacts with Y mole of OH minus ions, the concentration of OH minus ion becomes C alpha minus Y, and Y mole of water is produced. So now the concentration of OH minus is decreased to C alpha minus Y, and thus to regenerate this undissociated NH4 plus will again produce the Y mole of OH minus ions, and thus the concentration of NH4 plus, which was C alpha, can also be increased and it become C alpha plus Y. So according to the Lee Satterfield principle, equilibrium is established again going in the forward direction. Y mole of NH4 plus undissociated dissociate to give Y mole of OH minus. So as the concentration of OH minus is being maintained here, and so the pH of the buffer can also be maintained. You can see that the concentration of NH4 plus becomes C alpha minus Y. So this Y mole of NH4 plus ion again reacts with the Y mole of Cl minus ion and gives us the undissociated Y mole of NH4Cl, which is undissociated, my dear students, by the reaction between the Y mole of NH4 plus and Y mole of Cl minus. And thus the solubility of the salt decreases in this solution and pH remain maintained, my dear students. If what happens if we add the small amount of OH minus ion or base into this solution? So adding base in a small quantity, when we add base in the small quantity, again this concentration of OH minus ion will be disturbed. So due to addition of Z mole of OH minus ion, equilibrium is disturbed. So the concentration of OH minus becomes C alpha plus Z. So according to the Lee Schattel's principle, equilibrium shift towards the reactants and Z mole of NH4 OH is being produced. So this Z mole of NH4OH is produced by the reaction of Z mole of OH minus ion with Z mole of NH4 plus ion. Thus the concentration of NH4 plus ion is being decreased, my dear students. Extra Z mole of NH4 plus combined with the, this extra Z mole of NH4 plus combined with the, it should be plus, extra Z mole of NH4 plus combined with the Cl minus, and then it gives us the NH4Cl solid. Extra Z mole of NH4 plus combined, extra Z mole of NH4 plus combined with the Cl minus to give NH4Cl. So NH4Cl, which is Z mole, Cl minus was X mole, that becomes X minus Z, and we get NH4 Z mole of NH4Cl, and thus the solubility of NH4Cl decreases in the solution due to the common ion effect. Now my, and thus the pH remain constant. Now my dear students, we have a question. With example, explain that the solubility of salt decreases due to the common ion effect. Taking the example of buffer solution. Then while we were studying, my dear students, we have shown that the solubility of salt decreases when there is a common ion effect. Now let us understand with the example. In the buffer, which is the acidic buffer solution, my dear students, we have weak acid CH3COOH, the salt of weak acid with the strong base is CH3COONa. Now there is an equilibrium established between the CH3COOH and the ion CH3CO- and H+, and this salt completely dissociates or ionizes to give X mole of CH3CO- and X mole of Na+. Now suppose from outside if we add Y mole of OH-, so to maintain the pH, my dear students, this Y mole of OH- reacts with Y mole of H+. This Y mole of OH- reacts with the Y mole of H+ and gives Y mole of water, and thus the concentration of H+, which was C alpha, now it has been decreased to C alpha minus Y. To maintain the pH, my dear students, Y mole of CH3COOH, this Y mole of CH3COOH dissociates and gives us again Y mole of H+ ions. Thus the C alpha minus Y plus Y becomes C alpha, but the concentration as this extra Y mole of CH3COOH dissociate, extra Y mole of CH3COOH dissociate, it gives Y mole of CH3CO minus and Y mole of H plus. So this Y mole of H plus makes the concentration of H plus again C alpha, and then the pH is maintained, but the concentration of CH3CO minus becomes C alpha plus Y. So this extra Y mole of, as this extra Y mole of CH3CO minus ion available, they react with Na plus and give Y mole of CH3COONa. So the ionic balance is maintained, but the solubility of salt CH3COONa is decreased due to the common ion effect. So now what happens, this extra Y mole of CH3, this Y mole of CH3CO minus reacts with X mole of NH for Na plus and produces Y mole of CH3COONa. As this Y mole of CH3COONa produced into the solid state, we can say that the solubility of CH3COONa, which is a salt, decreases, and the concentration of Na plus turns out to be X minus Y. So this is how, my dear students, the solubility of this salt decreases due to the common ion effect CH3CO minus produced or OH minus when added to the acidic buffer solution. Now calculating the pH for the buffer solution, we know that in basic buffer is prepared by mixing weak base and salt of weak base with the strong acid. So we have here weak base is BOH, the salt of weak, the salt of weak base with strong acid is we have weak base is BOH, the salt of weak base with the strong acid is BA. So BA ionizes completely to gives us B plus and A minus. BOH partially ionizes and create an equilibrium to gives us B plus and OH minus. We know that the concentration X is quite greater than the concentration C alpha. So for this particular equation, or for this equilibrium, we can write KB is equal to concentration of B plus multiplied by concentration of OH minus divided by the concentration of BOH, and therefore the concentration of OH minus is equal to KB multiplied by concentration of BOH divided by B plus. By taking logarithm both the side, we can find out POH is equal to PKB plus log of concentration of B plus divided by concentration of BOH. You can see that this minus sign has inverted BOH to go to the denominator and B plus to go to the numerator. Now, my dear students, this B plus concentration, if you look into this equilibrium, the B plus concentration actually is your X plus C alpha. The B plus concentration is X plus C alpha, but we know that X is quite greater than C alpha, and therefore X plus C alpha we can approximately write is equal to X, and that is why this concentration of B plus mostly comes from the BA, and BA is the salt, my dear students. So for the concentration of B plus, we can write the concentration of salt. So for this concentration, we will write the concentration of salt, my dear students. For concentration of B plus, we can write the concentration of salt. For concentration of BOH, we can write the concentration of base. So the same equation, now we can write it in this form, my dear student, that POH is equal to PKB plus log of concentration of salt divided by concentration of base. This is the equation using which we can find out the POH of this buffer solution, or of this buffer, basic buffer solution. So my dear students, you can see that I have written the same thing here. At salt of weak base is with strong ionized completely in buffer solution. So concentration of B plus is approximately the concentration of B plus, that is X plus C alpha, but X is equal to greater than C alpha, and therefore concentration of B plus, basically it comes from the concentration of salt, and concentration of BOH is the concentration of base, and thus we can write POH is equal to PKB plus log of salt divided by base. Now we are very aware that POH plus pH is equal to 14, and therefore pH is equal to 14 minus POH. So pH of buffer solution is equal to 14 minus POH. So we can calculate the POH using this equation, and then whatever the value we get, if we subtract that value from 14, we will get the pH of this buffer solution. So even the basic buffer solution, we can calculate the pH. Now, my dear students, we have a new question. Can you see the screen, my dear students?
Yes, sir.
What is written question? Can you read?
What happens if the concentration of weak acid and the concentration of salt are equal?
Equal. So it is very interesting to study, my dear students, that what happens if the concentration of this salt and concentration of acids are equal. We know that we have the formula pH of buffer, that is acidic buffer, is equal to pKa plus log of salt divided by acid. Now if the concentration of salt and concentration of acids are equal, what happens? pH is equal to pKa plus log of X by X, that is log of 1. But log of 1 is equal to 0, and therefore the pH is equal to pKa. So my dear students, please remember that if we take the molar concentration of weak acid and salt same, the pH of buffer solution will be equal to the pKa of the acid. And thus, to prepare the buffer solution of required pH, we can take, or we can choose acid whose pH, whose pKa value is close to the required pH value. Please remember, my dear students, if, and that is what we can understand with one example. So we will take the acid whose pKa value is very similar to the desired pH that we want to prepare. pKa value of acetic acid is 4.76, and therefore making the buffer of pH is equal to 4.76, we take equimolar solution of salt and acid, so that pH of buffer will be 4.76, because we have just seen that pH is equal to pKa if the concentration of salt is equal to concentration of acid. The same we can write for the base also. Now we have the next question. For conjugate acid base pair, BH plus and B. See, in the previous equation, calculation, we have taken base as BOH and we have taken the acid as BA. But now what do they say? They say that suppose your base is B, instead of taking base BOH, they want us to take base as B. So if we have base, my dear students, if we have base is equal to B, then it's conjugate acid will be B plus H plus, that is BH plus. So this base, B is base, BH plus is conjugate acid. So we can easily say that for the conjugate acid base pair, BH plus and B, derive an equation to calculate the pH of basic buffer. So this also, this B and BH plus can also be utilized to make the buffer solution, and we need to calculate the pH of that buffer solution based on pK value of acid. So let us try to do this. This base, when reacts with water, it produces BH plus and OH minus. As we know that for basic buffer, my dear students, pOH is equal to pKa plus log of BH plus divided by B. What is B? B is base, that is the concentration of base, and BH plus is the concentration of here acid, but not actually acid, it is conjugate acid, or that is what we can say, it is the salt, because we know that the concentration of salt is equal to the concentration of B minus. So we can write it this way, log of BH plus divided by B, that is the pOH is equal to pKa log of conjugate acid concentration BH plus divided by the concentration of base B. Now we know that pH is equal to pOH is equal to pKw, and pKa plus pKw is equal to is also equal to pKw. Therefore pOH is equal to pKw minus pH, and pKb is equal to pKw minus pKa. Let us put these values into the equation for pOH. So we can write pOH is equal to pKw plus log of conjugate acid BH plus log of concentration of conjugate acid BH plus divided by the concentration of base B. Instead of pOH, we can write pKw minus pH. Instead of pKw, we can write pKb, we can write pKw minus pKa plus log of concentration of conjugate acid BH plus divided by the conjugate base B. And thus, my dear students, we can find out the equation minus pH is equal to minus pKa plus log of concentration of conjugate acid BH plus divided by the conjugate base, divided by the concentration of conjugate base, or the same equation by multiplying each term with the minus one. We can write, my dear students, that pH is equal to pKa plus log of, now you can see that as this value is minus, we can invert it. So pH is equal to pKa minus log of conjugate acid BH plus divided by the concentration of base B. But to make this negative positive, we will invert. So numerator become denominator and denominator become numerator. And finally, we can write pH is equal to pKa plus log of concentration of base divided by the conjugate acid BH plus. So this is the formula to calculate the pH of buffer solution, which is prepared by using the conjugate acid base pair BH plus and B. pKa is the pKa value for the acid BH plus that we have taken for the calculation. So this is how, my dear students, we can even calculate the concentration of buffer solution, which is prepared from the conjugate acid base pair. The example for this, we can take it as the buffer solution that is prepared by ammonia, which is a base, and NH4 plus, which is conjugate acid. So it is buffer which is prepared from the ammonia NH3 and NH4Cl. You can say that, because NH4Cl will give us NH4 plus. So this is how, my dear student, you can understand this kind of, even this kind of problem is being asked. Now you can solve it using the above equation. Now we have the next question. What happens if the concentration of weak base and weak base salt with the strong acid is equal. So again, we can easily understand here, my dear students, that for even a basic buffer, if we take the concentration of salt and base is equal. Again, if we take the concentration of in the basic buffer, my dear students, if we take the concentration of our base and our salt is equal. Let us say it is equal to X. So we will have pH is equal to pKa minus log of 1. That is, pH is equal to pKa because log of 1 is equal to 0. So now, my dear students, we can understand the same with the example. If we want to prepare basic buffer from ammonia, which is weak base, and ammonium chloride.